Hi, Dan here, Scooter Magazine. Right, we're going to hopefully do a quick update on the Targa. As you may know, we had some little teething problems with the floats and the fuel jet spilling over. So that's hopefully all sorted now. So we're going to get it fired up and take it out for a test spin. If you want to see the history of this this series of videos, right through from buying this chassis from Sam at lambrettafinder.com through to getting the Nova certificate and all the other technical updates, then just have a look at the other videos and you'll soon catch up on that. But for now, when this scooter first came, it had this Targa engine came, it had a Jolimoto expansion chamber on, and we've fitted a, with never running that, we fitted the Clubman pipe to it because I wanted to retain the street sleeper look. So that has had the inevitable consequence of making the jetting now slightly richer than it should be. So I want to get out on a test ride, see how rich the jetting is, and then have a look at some options for just getting that leaned off slightly. I was going to do that the other day, but we had some problems with the fuel bowl filling up and leaking over, but we've cured that now. The other thing I'm going to do when I'm out on the test ride is just test this bit of kit, which is going to put the mobile phone in there and hopefully just do a bit of footage of the road. I'm worried that this will end up vibrating too much and the footage will be too shaky, but certainly this is good for if you're going to use your phone with sat nav or any other bits and pieces. But that's not my main interest right now. My main interest right now is this engine, the jetting, the pipe, and taking the thing out for a test ride and see how it looks and sounds. So let's just see if it'll fire up first, because I've fitted the new floats, but I haven't even tried to fire it up yet. So let's see if it will.
Right, immediately this feels a lot better than it did the other day. Those perforated fuel jets were obviously causing big problems down the bottom end. So we'll just give the engine a chance to warm up.
I hope you don't see a lovely thing there with the roads. These little ones are very, very twisty. And cars have a habit of them going quicker around the corner. I'm not leaving much room to them to break.
I think one other thing I'm going to do is just have a look at this seat, because it's it's brand new and it's incredibly slippy, and every time I'm gassing this throttle, it's making me slide off the back, and then I'm ending up trying to grab the throttles and the handlebars just to pull me back forward, and I'm not getting good control over the scooter as I'm riding. So I just need to sort this seat out. This pipe is giving me the look that I want. It's not hampering the sound of the twin as much as I was worried it might do. But it does feel to run out of gas very quickly, and I'm not sure at this stage, this early on, if that's the pipe itself or if it's just the over richness gassing it up. Oh, this is beautiful. It really is. It's just got that smooth zing to it. Actually, fucking hell, it's flying. I don't feel so much actually, it might be the pipe, I think it might be the gearing. I mean, I'm four tanking on for these twisty roads. You wouldn't feel so fast if you're out on the open road, but I'm loving this. This is a different beast altogether than what I read the other day. When we first got this and the tap jet, sorry, the floats, the pair of floats, we were unaware of that, obviously, and we were firing it up, and it was, obviously, thing wouldn't bloody tick over, it was buggy as hell, then I got it going, thought it might clear up, thought it might be sticking floats, and I assumed, because it was the first starter pipe I had on it, with this pipe and carb setup, I just thought it was too rich, but now that we've got these floats sorted out, it's a different beast altogether. Actually, the jetting feels pretty good. Is he going to stop and let me through? No, tosser. Thank you. Flies! I tell you what, these the chassis feels good as well. Liking the suspension, the tyres and the rim setup, it feels lovely. Bit lacking on that hill level, it is a very steep hill. I think perhaps just some changes to maybe the ignition timing and the jetting, just some tweaks, but we are not far off with that, not far off at all. Loving it. Right, let's see what disastrous footage we got out of our shaky little camera. I could see it was twisting everywhere and one thing and another, but that's the best we could do with this setup. I think we might revert to something a bit better in future. But as for now, for the Targa, pleased with that. I'm just going to have a look at some fine tuning. Over and out.
Right, back in the shed now. We've had that test ride, just a quick squirt around the block. I just wanted to do two things. One, see how the camera, the phone holder held up for using it as a camera, which in my opinion it was terrible. One thing I noticed straight away was that I couldn't tilt it horizontal to get the landscape shot, hence the camera switched to vertical to portrait, which isn't how you want to be shooting camera footage. And secondly, the vibration on handlebars was just ridiculous. It was worth it just to see if it was any good as a camera. I still rate the unit as a decent holder for the mobile phone to keep it waterproof. If you want to use the sat nav, that's fine, but in terms of doing the footage, and also I was using the iPhone cable for the earphones, so I was attached to the thing by a cable so that I could use the mic just to give some commentary, and again the sound quality of that was very poor, so I won't be using that setup again. I'll probably be reverting back to the Senna 10C Pro or something else like that, just to do more footage, more test rides. So that's that side of it. As far as the scooter goes, loving it. There's some very obvious immediate shortcomings, but you know, we haven't even got into the setup of it yet. So that particular engine came with the engine 4-speed gearbox on it, and that's got a close 1-2 and a close 3-4, but the gap between second and third is a little bit larger than you would want in deepest, darkest rural North Yorkshire, where there are lots of hills. And I just noticed on one of the hills in particular towards the end of the ride that the gap between second and third is quite noticeable. Also, it seems to run out of steam quite, the scooter rockets on when you gas it, but it runs out of steam quite quickly. Now, I think that's either the gearing just needs looking at in terms of the overall final drive ratio, and perhaps the jetting can just do a little bit cleaning up to make sure the box pipe isn't gassing up and it's restricting it that way. So it'll be one of those two things that need looking at in that respect. But we're at the beginning of this journey now, we've got the thing out on the road. I absolutely love it, but I want to get out now and do some longer test rides without all this camera strapped to me, because I was spending half my time thinking about what I was trying to say. Was the camera tilting? Was I going to jerk the cable out of its socket and lose all the audio? I want to take all that off now and just go out for a ride and get some miles on it. But once I've got a few more miles on it, then I'll have a better idea of what adjustments to make, and I'll keep you informed what the next step is. Stay tuned for the next video.